So I am a single mom of four children.
That's a lot to manage.
Yeah, it is.
Laura Weimer is frank about a lot of things most women would never admit. Her yard is a mess, her family is struggling, and she took a risk with her health for an abortion.
And there's just so much desperation there.
It was a baby Laura says she didn't want, couldn't afford, and came from what she claims is a sexual assault. So she searched for a clinic. In Missouri, where she lives, there's only one.
I just remember seeing on the map that my only option for help was in St. Louis, and I live in all the way across the state from that, and I have no way of getting there, no way of paying for that.
Under state law, she would have had to go twice, wait 72 hours, and she'd have to find someone to watch her kids. So instead, Laura paid another cost with a visit to this generation's version of a back alley. She looked on the internet for alternatives that wouldn't require a trip to the clinic, trying to end her pregnancy.
If I have this child, we're going to all live in a deeper, darker poverty than we are now. And if that means risking my own health, that's something I'm willing to do. And that's such a scary space.
An online marketplace outside the reach of safety regulators and medical professionals, where websites dangle pills they claim can end a pregnancy for a couple hundred bucks or less. Circa found no shortage of places offering abortion kits, even though the FDA warns against buying mifepristone, the abortion pill, online. Laura didn't buy that medication, but many women could. No doctors here, no laws, no restrictions, just skimpy instructions on websites written with broken English, including customer reviews that make no sense.
Women are seeking services in unsafe fashion because they can no longer access it in a legal way.
Groups like Planned Parenthood blame state laws they call restrictive. A 2015 study claims thousands of women have self-induced abortions they couldn't access otherwise. Pro-lifers debate those numbers and say the laws protect health and safety, making abortion clinics step up their game.
These abortion facilities, the abortion industry, they have a vested interest in making the claim that, you know, women are doing these back alley abortions because they want restrictions to go away in the United States.
But one of the biggest challenges has disappeared.
The Supreme Court vote ruled 5-3.
A Texas state law billed as a way to improve clinic quality was struck down by the Supreme Court. The ruling, met with tears at this Planned Parenthood office in Kansas, will likely trickle down to other states.
This is a huge day for reproductive rights.
Groups like Students for Life, though, a national nonprofit advocating against abortions, don't see the victory here.
You know, I'll say my goal isn't to make abortion just illegal, it's to make it unthinkable. Because if all you do is change laws, women are still going to be in these situations not knowing what resources exist. And so we need to bridge the gap.
The group takes a grassroots approach, saying it teaches strategies on how to defend the unborn and creating ways to support women who decide to keep the baby. They won't sway them all.
You want to make sure everybody is aware this is not your only option, but what if that's the option I choose?
I think that if that's the option that a woman chooses, I think that we need to come alongside her with post-abortion support and healing.
That applies even to the women who go to unregulated places on the web, the wild west of abortion options, where pills can supposedly be shipped around the world.
No one can tell for certain what's legit and what isn't.
An activist, Erin Mattson with Repro Action, says that puts women in real danger. We're talking about medical risks from bogus pills, rip-offs from scam artists, and even potential prosecution if something goes wrong.
More and more women are taking matters into their own hands and getting criminally charged for that. So it's terrifying.
The most notable example, Purvi Patel, an Indiana woman serving 20 years in prison for feticide after prosecutors say she took abortion pills purchased online.
This is what abortion looks like today. And specifically, this is what abortion in a severely restricted climate can look like today.
And those restrictions vary. 28 states currently require waiting periods, some as long as 72 hours. 14 states require 2 trips before an abortion is performed. Pro-life groups say it's time women need to think about that decision.
And so our generation, our nation, poses abortion as this quick fix to their situation when really it's leaving them off hurting.
Laura Weimer disagrees. She says she has no regrets, even though what she found on the internet made her sick and didn't work. But she was so sure of her decision, she continued on and found a legal clinic across the state line, not far from home.
There's no way in hell I'm gonna let this put myself and my family through all of those challenges that we've already just pulled ourselves out of.